For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And hi again, everybody. Welcome again to another game of Granite State Challenge. Moving along nicely in this, our second round. We have five teams that have won second round games to move to the quarterfinals. Three more games this week and two others coming up, and the winners of those games also will advance into our quarterfinal round. So let's introduce you to the teams playing in tonight's second round contest. First of all, we have the team from Gorham High School. It enrolls approximately 179 students. Gorham is located in New Hampshire's Coos County.
My name is Chris, and I'm a senior.
I am Dan, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Ryan, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Tyler, and I'm a junior.
Joining us for the team is the coach, Terry Myers, and her alternate is Kyle Fortin, and they are the Huskies from Gorham High School. All right, we've met Gorham. Now let's introduce you to their opponents for tonight's game. This is the team from Nashua High School South. With its enrollment of some 2,300 students, Nashua High School South, located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Alden, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Mitch, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Kendall, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Erin, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program, the coaches, Neil Claffey and Catherine Poulin. And the alternate is William Goss IV, and they are the Purple Panthers from Nashua High School South. And our last introduction is to let you know who our judges are. And once again, this week, we say hello to Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger. All right, we are ready to go into our first round, a 10-point toss-up round. We play in four rounds. We still have a bonus round and a 60-second round ahead. But Gorham and Nashua South, these are 10-point toss-ups. Good luck, and here we go. What is the name of the plane Charles Lindbergh flew in 1927? Mitchell of Nashua South.
Spirit of St. Louis.
Spirit of St. Louis on his flight from New York to Paris. This physicist was the scientific director of the Manhattan Project. Mitchell of Nashua South.
Oppenheimer.
Oppenheimer is right. Often referred to as the father of the atomic bomb, J. Robert Oppenheimer is correct. This Austrian monk studied the inheritance of certain traits in pea plants. Dan of Gorham.
Mendel.
Mendel is right, laid the foundation for the modern study of genetics. Tell me now for 10 points, which islands were originally named the Sandwich Islands by Captain James Cook in 1778? Alden of Nashua South.
The Cook Islands.
Gorham. Sandwich Islands were originally named, and for the Hawaiian Islands. This New Hampshire poet was Poet Laureate of the United States, Chris of Gorham.
Robert Frost.
Can repeat it for Nashua South. This New Hampshire poet was Poet Laureate of the United States from 2006 to 2007. Poet Laureate's name is Donald Hall. The presence of this radioactive isotope of carbon in organic materials is the basis, Ryan of Gorham.
Carbon-14.
Carbon-14, to date archaeological, geological artifacts. Well done. Which story of slavery was first published in book form, Mitchell of Nashua South?
Uncle Tom's Cabin.
Uncle Tom's Cabin, back on March 20th of 1852. For 10 points, this New Hampshire politician broke with pro-slavery Democratic leaders in 1844, Mitchell of Nashua South.
Franklin Pierce.
I can repeat it for Gorham. This New Hampshire politician broke with pro-slavery Democratic leaders in 1844 and was cast out of the party. He is credited by some as the founder of the Republican Party. His name was Amos Tuck. In July 2000, prompted by an NAACP boycott, which state removed the Confederate flag from atop the State House, Chris of Gorham?
Mississippi.
Good try. I can repeat it, though, for Nashua South. In July 2000, prompted by an NAACP boycott, which state removed the Confederate flag from atop the State House dome after 38 years, then raised another such flag on State House grounds in the capital of Columbia? Erin.
South Carolina.
South Carolina is correct. The first newspaper in America, public occurrences, both foreign and domestic, was published in 1690 and suppressed after only one edition. In what city was it published? Alden of Nashua South.
Hartford.
Gorham. Dan.
Philadelphia.
It was Boston. Here we go for 10 points. Marlon Brando won a Best Actor Oscar. Alden of Nashua South.
The Godfather.
The Godfather is correct. What name beginning with the letter R is often used for the multiplicative inverse of a number? Alden of Nashua South.
Reciprocal.
Reciprocal is correct. This New Hampshire governor was the first head of the Social Security Board and served as U.S. ambassador to Great Britain from 1941 to 1945. The governor's name was John Winant. This center for the San Antonio Spurs attended Concord High School. Mitchell of Nashua South.
Tony Parker.
Gorham. His name is Matt Bonner. As a young boy, this African-American scientist was known as the plant doctor. Mitchell of Nashua South.
George Washington Carver.
George Washington Carver is correct. What is the only surviving species of the family of the primate family Hominidae? Ryan of Gorham.
Homo sapiens.
Homo sapiens is correct. Now for your next 10-point toss-up, we want you to identify the compact signed on November 11th, 1620. Mitchell of Nashua South.
Mayflower Compact.
The Mayflower Compact is right. This novella by French aviator Antoine de Saint-Alden of Nashua South.
The Little Prince.
The Little Prince. Well done. One of the first broadcasting jobs of this Dancing with the Stars host was hosting Granite State Challenge. Aaron of Nashua South.
Tom Bergeron.
Tom Bergeron was right here where I am. That's correct. Here we go for 10 points. This type of front forms when a mass of warm air meets a mass of cold air and no movement occurs. Alden of Nashua South.
A neutral front.
Gorham. It is a stationary front. For 10 points, in which state was Fort Ticonderoga captured by Ethan Allen, Mitchell of Nashua South?
Vermont.
I can repeat it for Gorham. In which state was Fort Ticonderoga captured by Ethan Allen and his Green Mountain Boys in 1775? Dan.
New York.
New York is correct. Identify the city whose citizens were given the right to vote in presidential elections. Alden of Nashua South.
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C., that coming under the 23rd Amendment. Holly Golightly is the free-spirited heroine. Erin of Nashua South.
Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Breakfast at Tiffany's, written by Truman Capote. Well done. What two-word name was given to the March 10th, 1992 U.S. presidential primary that included most southern states? Still used today to some degree, the two-word name is Super Tuesday. There's the sound ending our opening round. It's Nashua South getting the early lead after one round of play as we get ready for the bonus round. But before we get there, we're going to ask Lori Warner to join us, as she does each week. This round, on second round of competition, she's been meeting with the coaches and the alternates from the various teams. So right now, she's talking with the coach and alternate from Gorham High School.
Well, thank you, Jim. We've got Gorham High School here, and we're talking to our stand-in for the coach, Terry Myers. Now, you're here for Pete today, who couldn't make it.
Right. I'm filling in today as a assistant coach.
Yeah, and he didn't tell you that you got to be on camera.
No.
Hi, Pete. Thanks a lot. She really likes you. And I think you're going to be doing a lot of recess duty for her. Now, at the school, what do you do?
I'm a paraprofessional. Mm-hmm. I work with various students.
And how long have you been at the school?
3 years.
Yeah. Are you from that area?
I'm originally from upstate New York.
Okay, so, well, yeah. Pretty similar. Well, I mean, there's a lot of trees, a lot of hills.
Yeah, we like it here.
Yeah, the ones here are nice. And as far as preparation for the team, what did they have to do to get ready for coming down for the matches today? You know?
They've had various practices, and mm-hmm. Pete usually holds them after school. They do a number of practices.
Yeah, I think most of the other teams mentioned snacks, so it's kind of like the lore.
Okay, yes.
All right, well, good luck today. Thanks so much
Thank
for standing
you.
In. And Kyle Fortin, you are a junior, the alternate on the team.
I am.
Now, I was asking you what you do at school, and you told me the whole bunch of stuff, golf and skiing, you play guitar.
I do.
Yeah? Yep. How long have you been playing guitar?
For about 2 years.
Yeah?
Yep.
And are you getting good?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. In a rock band yet?
No.
No. Then you're not going to take over in Pearl Jam or anything?
No.
Okay.
Not quite.
And are you on the golf team at school?
I am.
Yeah.
I am. Yep.
You know, Tiger Woods needs a successor these days.
He definitely does.
He definitely does. So, you know, perhaps you could think about that.
I could step up for that. Yeah.
All right. And then any other organizations at school that you are involved
with? I am also in SAD, mm-hmm. Students Against Destructive Decisions.
Oh, all right. I thought it was drunk driving, but okay.
Oh, they changed that.
Well, it fits.
It does.
I'm showing my age, aren't I? Okay. Well, anyway, it's time for us to get back to the studio. So best of luck to you guys, and thanks so much. Over to you, Jim.
Thank you very much, Laurie, and thank you to Terry and for Kyle for joining us for the program this evening. We head into our second round, which is our bonus round. We continue to ask the 10-point toss-up questions. Get your toss-up correctly, and your team has a chance at bonus points. So here we go, Gorham and Nashua South. What is the term for a less offensive word or phrase used for one, Alden of Nashua South?
Euphemism.
Used for one that is more direct but likely to offend. A euphemism is correct. Well done. So over to Nashua South we go. Alden, you're the team captain. You'll speak for them. So talk it over and choose from these categories. A-OK, field trip, or high school musical. A-OK, field trip, or high school musical. Alden?
High school musical.
Let's go with high school musical. Identify these musicals that are often performed at high schools. Harold Hill sells band instruments to the trusting... Say again?
The Music Man.
Correct. A hip-thrusting rock and roll superstar is drafted into the Army in this musical.
Bye Bye Birdie.
Correct. The Founding Fathers sing and dance as they work toward...
1776.
Easy as that. Very well done. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. For 10 points, this Washington, D.C. school is the world's only liberal arts college for the hearing impaired. Alden of Nashua. Gorham. It's called Gallaudet University. This Cherokee silversmith invented a system for writing the Cherokee language in 1821. Alden of Nashua.
Sequoia.
Sequoia is right for the 10 points. All right, back to Nashua South we go. We have A-OK, we have a field trip, and we have Cry Uncle. A-OK, field trip, or Cry Uncle?
A-OK.
A-OK it will be. We want you to identify these words with the letters A, O, and K in them in any order. Tree-dwelling marsupial found in Australia that eats eucalyptus leaves.
Koala.
Correct. State located in the south-central region of the United States.
Oklahoma.
Correct. Optical toy in a tube that produces pattern pieces.
Kaleidoscope.
Simple as that. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Let's go with a toss-up. This American impressionist painter is best known for her works depicting mothers and children. Her name is Mary Cassatt. What is the term for an island or islands of coral that partially or completely encircle a lagoon, Ryan of Gorham?
Atoll.
Atoll is right for your 10 points, so let's go over to Gorham for some bonus questions. Chris, you're the team captain. Choose from field trip, cry uncle, or rain, rain, go away. Field trip, cry uncle, or rain, rain, go
field
away.
Field trip.
Let's go with field trip. Identify these famous fields. Song inspired by John Lennon's memories of playing in the garden of a Salvation Army house.
Strawberry Fields Forever.
Correct, that's it. She played the flying nun and Gidget, now is in the TV drama Sally Brothers Fields. And Sisters.
Sally Fields. Sally Fields.
Correct. The final resting place of the souls of the heroic and virtuous in Roman mythology. And that is Elysian Fields. But you got 10 out of 15 on the bonus, and we go with another 10-point toss-up. Which U.S. president said in 1974, our long national nightmare is over? Alden of Nashua South.
Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford is correct. All right, over to Nashua we go. We have Cry Uncle. We have Rain, Rain, Go Away. And we've added Very Interesting. Cry Uncle. Rain, go away. Very interesting.
Cry Uncle.
Let's go with Cry Uncle. Identify the following famous uncles. Long lost brother of Gomez Adams.
Uncle Fester.
Correct. Symbol of the United States.
Uncle Sam.
Correct. Fictional narrator of African American folk tales.
Uncle Remus.
That is correct. Uncle Remus is right. 15 more on the bonus. And there's the sound ending our round, and Nashua High continues to hold on to the lead. It got back in round number one with our 62nd round coming right up. Before we get there, though, we are now going to take another time out, ask Lori to rejoin us, this time talking with the coaches and alternate from Nashua High School South.
Thank you, Jim. We've got Nashua High South as our team we're talking to right now, Coach Neil Claffey. Now, you have been with the team for how many years?
At least 15, maybe 20.
20 years. And how have you done? Have you guys ever taken the championship home?
No, we have not. We've come close. One year we reached the Final Four.
Oh, nice. Nice, nice. So, well, maybe this is a year.
You
know,
let's hope.
You never know. You never know. And your co-coach is Catherine Poulin. Now, how long have you been with the team, Catherine?
Since, I think, 2001 officially.
Okay. And how long have you been a teacher at the school?
This is my 12th year.
And what do you teach?
U.S. History and AP U.S. History.
Oh, wow. Okay. So that comes in very, very handy with the questions.
Absolutely. Okay. And it's a fun way of grading to meet the students.
Yeah. And do they behave well for the most part?
Absolutely.
You should see the face. And as far as preparation for the show today and for the challenge itself?
We've had a good time. I mean, I think one of the best things we did was we actually got some teachers to go against the team this past week, and they got their first scare.
The kids or the teachers?
The kids.
Oh, okay. All right. That makes a lot of sense. But now, how did you like it? Did the teachers beat you? This is Will. He's the alternate.
I wasn't there.
No, because you're the alternate?
Yeah.
Or were you swimming?
No.
Okay.
I had to go to English and take a test. So.
Oh, yeah. Silly things like
this. I was
like
not able to make it, unfortunately.
Well, now, you were swimming at school.
Yep.
And what is your big event?
I swim the 200 a lot, and I took third place last year at States,
so that was exciting. Yeah. And are you a junior or a senior this year?
Senior this year.
Oh, what are your plans for next year?
College.
Yeah. More studying.
Yeah.
Hopefully some swimming too, right?
Yeah.
All right, awesome. Yeah. Well, right now it's time for some more questions, so we've got to get back into the studio. Wish you the best of luck. Thanks so much for stopping in to chat. And it's back over to you, Jim.
All right, Larry, thank you. Laurie, thank you very much. And thanks to Neil and Catherine for participating along with us as coaches again this year. Right now, their team sits on top of a lead halfway through the game as we enter our 62nd round. In this round, we'll be asking 10 questions to each team. They will be given 10 points for every right answer, a bonus of 10 if they get that right in under a minute. So, Gorham, you do trail, so you get to choose the category first. It's not easy being green. Agency alphabet, a rose is a rose. It's not easy being green. Agency alphabet, a rose is a rose.
Agency alphabet?
Agency alphabet. And again, Chris, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. We want you to identify the federal agencies known by the following acronyms. Start the clock. CIA.
Central Intelligence Agency.
Correct. FBI.
Federal Bureau of Investigation.
Correct. DOD.
Department of Defense.
Correct. DOE.
Department of Energy.
Correct. CDC.
Center for Disease Control and Prevention.
Correct. ATF.
Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms.
Correct. EPA.
Environmental Protection Agency.
Correct. FCC.
Federal Communications Commission.
Correct. FDA.
Food and Drug Administration.
Correct. IRS.
Internal Revenue Service.
Boy, they know their agency alphabet. Ah, very well done. They got them all 10. That's 100. We'll bonus them 10 for getting them all right in under a minute. So congratulations, Gorham, for that performance. 110 points onto the scoreboard for you. Let's go over to Nashua South for It's Not Easy Being Green or A Rose is a Rose.
It's not easy being green.
It's not easy being green. Alden, I take your answer for the team as the captain. Identify the following related to the word green. Start the clock. Small-hearted creature who lives above Whoville.
The Grinch.
Correct. Major General of the Continental Army in the American Revolutionary War.
Daniel Green.
Nathaniel Green. Jennifer Aniston played this character on Friends.
Rachel Green.
Correct. Billy Joe Armstrong is the lead singer. Say again.
Green Day.
Correct. William Defoe plays this supervillain of the
Green Goblin.
Correct. United States Army Special Forces.
Green Berets.
Correct. Green Ogre, created by William
Shrek.
Correct. Large mascot for a vegetable company.
The Giant. Jolly Green Giant.
Correct. The green creature Dr. Bruce Banner turns into.
The Hulk.
Correct. Well, judges, think of that. And 1908 novel by Canadian author Lucy Maud Montgomery.
Anne of Green Gables.
That is correct, judges. They're going to give them 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round, so very well done for both teams in the 62nd round. 90 points onto the board for Nashua South. Things tightened up a little bit there in that round, but Nashua South holding on to the lead. It got back in round number one. All right, Gorham and Nashua South, 10-pointers the rest of the way. Good luck, and here we go. What is the only even prime number? Mitchell of Nashua South.
2.
2 is correct. This computer language was developed in 1964. Dan of Gorham.
Binary code.
I can repeat it for Nashua South. This computer language developed in 1964 by John George Kemeny and Thomas Eugene Kurtz at Dartmouth College. It is. I'm sorry, I missed who that was, judges.
I think it was me.
Aaron, okay.
HTML.
We're looking for BASIC. This planet was long thought to have canals because of the dark lines labeled canali. Ryan of Gorham.
Mars.
Mars is correct for your 10 points. Now tell me, which state, the farthest west in the Confederacy, was readmitted to the Union on March 30th, 1870? Chris of Gorham.
Texas.
Texas is right. Now for 10 points. What name is given to the strait that once stretched from Siberia to Alaska? Alden of Nashua South.
The Bering Strait.
The Bering Strait, which American Indians probably came to this country from Asia. The name for these small floating plants and animals at the base of the food chain in oceans, seas, and lakes is derived from the Greek word for errant. Errant of Nashua South.
Plankton.
Plankton is right. The Purple Heart bears the profile of this Mitchell of Nashua South.
George Washington.
Wow, that's good anticipation. The bears the profile of this U.S. president who first established the award as the badge of military merit. Very well done. Here we go for 10 points. This Russian physician and writer once said, "Medicine is my lawful wife and literature is my mistress." Some of his works include The Cherry Orchard, The Three Sisters, Tyler of Gorham.
Anton Chekhov.
Anton Chekhov is correct. Now for 10 points. Lieutenant William L. Colley Jr. was the only military man court-martialed and convicted for a March 16, 1968 massacre in Vietnam when several hundred, Alden of Nashua South.
The My Lai Massacre.
That is exactly right. When several hundred unarmed civilians were killed, in which hamlet did this event occur? My Lai is right. The annexation of this state into the Union in 1845, Alden of Nashua South.
Texas.
Well, we're getting all kinds of anticipation tonight, aren't we? In 1845, led Mexico to break relations with the United States. Texas is correct. This co-founder of Solidarity, the first independent trade union in a Soviet bloc country, won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1983 and was president of Poland from 1990 to 95. His name was Lech Walesa. All right, we have just under 2 minutes to play. What is the harmonic mean of the integers 6, 8, and 12? And if you think you need paper for that, you can do it, but we'll give you a minute. Kinjal of Nashua?
12.
Gorham? Dan?
8.
Well, 8 is the correct answer. So we go with another 10-point toss-up with about a minute and a half to play in our game. Babe Ruth hit 60 home runs in 1927. Who hit 61 home runs in 1961? Alden of Nashua?
Roger Maris.
Roger Maris is correct. Which name beginning with the letter A identifies the 100-eyed mythological giant who guarded Io after she was changed into a heifer? We're looking for is Argus. Minute to play. What name is given today to the cave in which Tom and his friend Becky Thatcher get lost in the novel The Adventures of Tom Sawyer? This cave is in Hannibal, Missouri. It is the Mark Twain Cave. Which term is used in chemistry to describe a reaction that shows characteristics of both acids and bases? Amphoteric is what we're looking for. Let's try this one. Which term is used in zoology to describe any appendage adapted for seizing, grasping, and holding on, especially in reference to tails of monkeys? Ryan of Gorham.
Prehensile.
Prehensile is correct. Identify the person who is a specialist in the deformities, disease, and injuries of the skeletal structure of the body. He is an osteopath. Identify the almost clear yellowish liquid that is the largest component of the blood. Orion of Gorham.
Plasma.
We'll give you 10 more points as the buzzer sounds, ending the game. And it will be Nashua South in another high-scoring game for both teams, moving on into the quarterfinals with a win tonight over Gorham. So congratulations to Nashua South High School. You move on into the quarterfinals coming up not too far down the road. For Gorham High School, congratulations on your first win and for your game well played this evening. For you folks at home, I'm sure you're ready to do it all over again. Another second round game coming up 1 week from tonight. This game will pit the teams from St. Thomas Aquinas High School against Laconia High School. That's our game next week. We thank you for watching. See you then. Good night, everybody.